The secret message was painted and completed by Francois Boucher in 1767. He was a very well-known French painter. He perhaps might have been the most celebrated painter and decorative artist during the 18th century. However, according to Making Up the Rococo, Francois Boucher and His Critics by Melissa Hyde, and Rethinking Boucher by Melissa Hyde and Mark Ledbury, his tremendous influence on a wide range of decorative arts produced in a variety of media both in France and abroad receives little attention in the books under consideration. Boucher is known for his idyllic and voluptuous paintings on classical themes, decorative allegories, and pastoral scenes. His works reflect inspiration gained from such artists as Peter Paul Rubens and Antoine Watteau. The secret message was done in oil paint on canvas and is found in one of the oldest museums in Germany. The museum is called Herzog Anton Ulrich Museum. It houses some of the most important masterworks of famous and influential painters. Soft greens and pinks that are associated with the Rococo style are present in this painting. The colors are so delicate and so peaceful. There's tranquility in the scene, and there is also this mythological feeling. The glimmer of the lady reading and the curving forms are typical of the Rococo style. There is a lot of texture achieved in this painting. The trees, the bushes, the flowers, and the fabric all have texture. The dress and the fabric underneath the hat especially have texture and volume. They are almost architectural. The use of space and balance is very lovely in the large, light dress. White pink flowers and the white bird create contrast, which highlights her face even more than the glimmer already does. The soft blue ribbon tied around the white bird, which appears to be the messenger, is like the one on the lady's hat. The other paintings of ladies done by Boucher seem so superficial. Artifice mattered greatly, and you could not see much past the makeup and the beauty. It was always just about the surface with those ladies, and artifice was what those paintings were about. However, this painting seems to show the lady in her true form. Since no one knows where she is, she does not hide who she truly is. She is not very self-conscious of how she looks, and she's even barefoot. The sculpted angels have a diagonal form, which suggests that Boucher was using techniques from past his time. Two or maybe all of the baby angels seem to be pointing at the lady in hiding. The one in the middle seems to be telling the one in front of him about the lady. The three angels and the white bird are the only witnesses to the lady and her secret letter.
The name of this artwork is called A Stylish Conversation, also known as Garden of Love, and it was done in the era of the Rococo. It was done by Peter Paul Rubens in 1630. Rubens was an established Flemish painter who had an emphasis on color, movement, and sensuality. He is one of the most distinguished artists of his time. Rubens illustrates the scene of aristocrats engaged in the activity of making pleasant conversation, modeling up-to-date fashion and etiquette, and the art of courting one another. This painting is understood to show the life of aristocracy demonstrated by the upper class. The word conversation in the title goes deeper than the mere act of talking. It is a form of interaction and gathering to a particular group of people who are up to date in style and modern topics. The painting aims to display a new social class, which takes place in noticeable leisure of the individuals. Peter Paul Rubens utilizes a style that he frequently uses in his other paintings, which is his use of the raw red. As you can see in the fabric of this gentleman, the color really stands out in contrast to the colors that are next to it. Rubens wanted to emphasize the expensive taste that these aristocrats had in the way that they dressed. The way that he painted the texture of their clothes and the use of the colors and shadowing made it easily distinguishable that they wore the finest of satin and lace. The painting shows two columns that mount upward towards the figure of Venus. The goddess of love, Venus, can be seen here as a sculpture riding a dolphin. Venus watches over the festivities which are taking place in the scene. On the left side, there is a reluctant couple that is off to the side being pushed by Cupid. Peter Paul Rubens actually draws himself in the portrait, as this couple is him and his wife Helen. Two next to them show an unequal interest towards each other, where the man clearly yearns for attention while the woman is more lackadaisical. In the middle of the painting, there is an illustration of three women with three different silky dresses which represent the Neoplatonism in the work. One lady is having a conversation, the other looks towards the heavens, while the other one glances at the viewer. The upper half of the painting is taken up by chubby cherubs gracefully floating through the portrait, which gives off an angelic presence. A direct quote from the book Rubens by Felipe de Montebello says, "All that was primitive and direct in the Kermesse is disposed here in more refined aristocratic gestures, and Rubens has thoughtfully supplied urging amours for the ladies who are about to succumb to the advances to the gallant men." This admirable picture is a very summary of Rubens' optimism and love of life. Peter Paul Rubens' A Stylish Conversation, also known as Garden of Love, shows the true lifestyle of the aristocrats and how they lavishly spend their time.